honky-tonk. It was a different scene. No IPAs, no skinny jeans. Things are in, then they're out. But the thing that the cool kids are all saying now is country's coming back. Buy some boots and get a hat.
All right, Taylor Branch, are you ready?
Yes, sir.
Let's go. All right, we got Taylor Branch here with the Lone Star Ramblers right out of Gatesville. How you doing, my friend?
Man, doing great, brother. Doing great.
Hey, man, we appreciate you joining today with Bandwagon TV, our joyride. We are driving through Gatesville. Taylor, we are so excited to have you. I know you got a lot going on. So for us, drive by, you're really just right up the road from Lampasas where we are. But just to spend some time, and I wanted you to tell a lot of the people, especially here in the Hill Country, what you got going on. But before we do that, if you don't mind, Taylor, let our fans know, people who are familiar with Taylor Branch and the Lone Star Ramblers, people who aren't, that, or people just in general want to learn more about you. If you don't mind, tell us a little bit about you, yourself, your band, where you're from, and a little bit about your musical influences.
Yeah, so Taylor Branch, Lone Star Ramblers, based out of Gatesville, Texas. We are a Texas country band with a whole lot of rock and roll, southern rock influences. Band consists of five of us: Brent Williams on steel and lead, kind of doing utility work; Corey Porter on drums; Wes Tucker on bass; and then Tucker Jones on lead. Man, we just have a lot of fun. We love playing music, and it's really kind of just our passion, and just have a whole lot of fun all along the way. Musical influences, man, range from all over the place. I grew up on, my dad's a jazz musician, so I grew up on a lot of that stuff. But as far as music goes, with things that I listened to as a child and kind of grew up around, Eric Johnson, the Eagles, Marshall Tucker, Allman Brothers, and the influences more today is just kind of all kinds of different stuff. Whiskey Myers, the Stones, Giovanni and the Hired Guns. I've really been jamming a lot of them lately.
Yeah, they're great.
Man, I just kind of all kinds of different sort of stuff. Turnpike, Troubadour, one for me.
Yep.
So yeah, man.
What we're doing this season here with Bandwagon TV Joyride, I wanted to mention, because of the music, and I'm also wanting to plug your Kickstarter here in a second, but all kind of twining and coming together, is that this season, just with music in general, you got the hospitality, you got restaurants and bars, just really, it's been a struggle. It's been an extreme struggle for a lot of us. And so I wanted to mention that a little bit, and maybe it's coinciding with this, but I ask pretty much every single guest of ours is if there's a stumbling block or hurdle that they had to overcome. We love, as Americans, as really people in general, I think around the world, they love an underdog story of overcoming those obstacles. And I was just wondering, from you personally or as a band, is there something that maybe that's happening now with the Kickstarter, with maybe coming back from Dallas back to Gatesville? Maybe it was leaving Gatesville for Dallas. Is there one particular thing that comes to mind that thinking about, wow, I am extremely proud that I overcame this to get me to where I am right now?
Yeah, absolutely. So I don't know what it is. One, I feel like people, artists in general, find a whole lot of obstacles, because it's very hard in the music industry and art in general. That goes for videographers and photographers, painters, just arts in general. There is no A, B, C, and D. A lot of friends, you know, if you're going to go to a trade, you go learn the trade. There's steps, and it takes hard work. I'm not saying it doesn't take hard work, but a lot of times, like, there's steps to kind of lead you through what your next step is. I think that's one of the biggest hurdles and stumbling blocks for most artists, is there is no A, B, C, D end result. You get to do music for a career. You got to share the stories on them, because it helps other folks, that's down and out. A lot of our songs are about that stuff, and overcoming it or working through it. And one of our songs, Hard Times, that song is I wrote our little boy, my youngest of my three kiddos. We found out 2 weeks after he was born that he had a genetic disorder called congenital adrenal hyperplasia. And most of that song was kind of sketched in a notepad sitting in a hospital room. And we're fortunate, we could be in a situation where it was a lot worse. We were humbled by it, and we realized we were fortunate. It's still hard, because you never, your mind tells you how things are going to be, and your mind kind of tells you how life is going to go. And that's not always how that works. That was a big thing for us. And he's an amazing gift. Going through that, it opened a door, and I was like, man, I gotta write something and kind of talk about this. And that song's about, like, talking to your spouse, like, look, we're gonna be okay, we'll figure this out, walk with me, dealing with the hard times. So, you gotta be positive in it, because it was terrible. We had to go through that, and it's terrible. That's something that we're gonna have to kind of learn and adjust and live life with and overcome. But at the same time, like, if you let yourself get too negative on that stumbling block, you can't see, like, hey, man, there's somebody else dealing with this, and I can help by sharing my message and sharing my song, kind of allowing somebody else to kind of see a deep part of you that, you know, you and your significant other, you and your family have struggled with, or you personally have struggled with. So on stumbling blocks, I mean, that's kind of my thing. Like, it's just, I don't want to say bring them on, but they're a great part of the process of trying to make songs and live life and learn and grow and get better. It's kind of that no pain, no gain sort of thought, I guess, for me with struggles.
Yeah, I love what you just said. It's part of the process. And obviously you need some of that to write those songs that'll teach everyone lessons, not just yourself. I really appreciate everybody at least sharing a bit of where they come from, whether it's a struggle or not. But it's been such a crazy year, and we all know that. And so I don't want to say that so many times, but I just think it's the music industry. I don't think enough people are talking about what's going on with specifically this industry. And so I'm just trying to shed some light. So with your help and others, I really do appreciate it. I think it goes a long way. But hey, I appreciate from really everything that you just said, and thank you again for sharing even your intimate, you know, family things. You have no idea. I love when musicians are just genuine and can be authentic. So thank you so much. But we gotta get into the lightning round. So we're gonna get a little off topic here, and I want to circle back around to some exciting things that you're doing. But Taylor, I gotta ask you, are you ready for the lightning round?
Born ready.
All right, let me pull over. I gotta pull the white lightning over and we're gonna get into it. I hope you're ready. We're about to enter the lightning round in the white lightning. I hope you're ready, Taylor. All right, good. All right, before we get in, I've been promoting local, really Hill Country High School football. Just because of everything going on, it's been a difficult season. I was just reading that, you know, 15 teams had to cancel cancel their playoff game because of COVID. So you think about these seniors that have played 3-4 years, and now all of a sudden the season's cut short. So it's devastating. So anyways, props to really every school, and really not just the football team, but the band and the faculty. But today I'm promoting again our hometown team, which is the Lampasas Badgers. They got a big game this Saturday against CC, that's Corpus Christi Miller. It's going to be a barn burner on Saturday. But I wanted to also give you an opportunity. We've been promoting local businesses. Do you have a local business that you want to promote with us here today?
Of course, you gotta love your local businesses, and really, to me, like, we've got a lot of great businesses that are in our corner. So there's several, you know. First and foremost, Chad Hill, Bare Bones Barbecue. If you're looking for good barbecue, the guy's done some phenomenal stuff for the music scene here in Gatesville. Great spot. You need to check that out. If you haven't been over here and got barbecue, check that place out. Definitely worth stopping in. Texas Event Station, again, they've been super big parts right now with our Kickstarter helping us out. If you're looking for a great wedding venue, check them out. And then there's a company, actually, so it's not as local, but it's a Texas company, Red Dirt Michelada Mix out of Lubbock, Texas. We just started kind of an endorsement with them. If you're a Michelada drinker, that stuff is delicious.
That's awesome. That's a good sponsor to have. I mean, that's a good.
On and on. It's got Mayberry Metal. If you're needing metal buildings, I'm telling you, if you need somebody, holler at me. I know a lot of folks.
Yeah, we'll provide a list. It's going to be sponsored by you.
There you go.
Thank you very much for sharing that. We're gonna promote and help promote them. And I also know that this weekend you got a show coming up. So before we get into that and help promote your music and your Kickstarter,
yeah,
I gotta get you in the lightning round. So here we go. I got I think a few things that might get you on the edge of your seat here for the audience. So all right, here we go. Let's go. Let's do this. All right, Taylor Branch. I gotta ask you: beer or whiskey? All right, I think I know, and I really hope that you say this answer when I ask you your favorite beer. What is it?
Lone Star.
There you go. See, I was... It's become my favorite. It's become my go-to. $6.99 for a six-pack at Stripes. Dude, you can't beat it. It's, And not only that, they're bringing, like, different ales around, like in the lager, the Mexican lager. Yes. All right. Can we see that can again?
Yeah, absolutely.
I think, bring it back just a little bit. Yeah, a little bit. There you go. That is, I think, one of the most, I love logos and art, and so call me a weirdo, but it's one of the most beautiful cans I've ever seen.
No, yeah, hands down, like, I'm not going to lie. When these came out, I was just super excited because I was like, well, it's another Lone Star beer. I'm going to drink it.
Yeah.
But I had to get the can. Like, I've got several of the cans because I'm like, I like the can. Like, who knows when they're going to print these again? Like, hopefully they keep doing different stuff. Like, it's I'm a Lone Star blue guy. Always on my Lone Star a lot, you know.
Okay.
But I drink Red Sea. I drink Lone. I'm not going to lie. Lone Star is Lone Star.
If you're also looking for a beer sponsor, why not go with Lone Star?
We're trying, man. We've been working on them pretty hard. I don't know. We've had a hard time getting them on board with it, but we're working on it. We got our Michelada mix. Now we got to get our beer on board.
Hey, so we'll keep pushing.
If you're watching Lone Star, please give me a call.
They're getting a tag on this. They're getting a tag on this, my friend. Because we talked about Red Dirt Country, Southern Rock, I have to ask you this. Whiskey Myers or the Rolling Stones?
Okay, so I'm going to have to say Rolling Stones, only because without Rolling Stones, I don't know if Whiskey Myers would be. I don't know. I'm just saying, I feel there's some influences. I love them both very much, but I feel like I have to go longevity, Rolling Stones. I have a sneaking suspicion Whiskey Myers is going to be the younger generation's Rolling Stones, is my prediction.
Okay, that's huge. That's a huge prediction, but I will take it. You're right. Rolling Stones, they will tell you all day that they had a huge influence on Southern Rock, on blues, and you can see it in their music.
Yep.
You can hear it in their music. Whiskey Myers is the same thing. So I'm not saying that they're on the same level, but to pick one or the other, it's kind of tough. So I appreciate that answer. You can't go wrong with it.
My heart is torn even feeling like I'm... It's like picking one of his, you know?
Yeah. All right, Taylor, if we were driving coast to coast, what musician would you have as your co-pilot?
I'm going to go on Johnny Cash. Of all people, like the amount of story and the way he's blended so many styles of music, I think he'd just be a very interesting person. And I think maybe if we drove all the way across the country, we'd have enough time to maybe hear half of the stories, maybe, you know.
Maybe. Hey, you might get him to
assumption.
To feature on a new single as well.
Yeah.
If we were driving on this road trip and we had a chance to look through your phone through a playlist, is there a song or musician that would surprise us?
Probably a lot that would surprise you. I'm very big on, like, for me, I found that for me to embrace music and really love music, I always feel like I'm trying to expand musically. I love all music. Now, there's music I don't like as much, but I listen to everything. So when it's like hip hop, from like old school hip hop stuff to like new hip hop stuff to like hardcore metal punk, a lot of rockabilly in there. Then there's like classic country, some modern country, lots of Red Dirt country, Texas country. Like I said, I'm all over the place. Like, to me, there's a well-written song is a well-written song. Good music is good music. So to me, like, I'm not really a music snob so much, man. If I enjoy it and it's got a good beat, I'm probably going to listen to it at some point.
Yeah, and I know we talked earlier about one of our, I think we shared this in common, is that one of our playlists, our favorite playlist, is the Rap Caviar in Spotify, and it's legit.
Enjoy a good song, yeah. End of the day, just enjoy a good song.
Absolutely. All right. Well, hey, you're doing great. Last question, because we're feeling festive here with Bandwagon TVs. We're about to enter holiday season. I have to ask you this. At the Thanksgiving dinner table, what's the first thing you're grabbing?
Turkey.
All right. Do you bake it, fry it?
Hands down. Smoke it.
You smoke it. How do you smoke I've never smoked it before. So for our audience, if you haven't, what's the process of smoking a turkey?
I'm very proud of my barbecuing skills. My smoking. I'm normally going to start with about 12 hours worth of brine, mix me up a brine, do a good brine on it, take it out, dry it, you know, pat it dry, do a good dry rub on it. I'm normally going to split the backbone out of it and then lay it out flat. Man, it cooks quicker. You don't get your traditional, like, you don't get to stuff it. And then literally just misting it with a good mixture of Lone Star beer and apple juice.
That was great. We really appreciate all those answers. I mean, especially, I know it's coming from the heart. And so thank you so much. And also, you sound like a bit of a prude when it comes to barbecuing and grilling.
I'm pretty serious about my barbecue.
So we wanted to get, before, we're going to have to ask for a song before we kick you out. But before we do that, I wanted to ask, you got a few really, and actually a lot going on, because I know Kickstarter isn't easy. And really, the process is extremely difficult. And people aren't familiar with really how much work it takes to make a successful campaign. Before we get into that, I just wanted to help promote you. So how do we find you? How do we listen to you with the Lone Star Ramblers?
All of them. We're trying to figure a couple out. My age is showing a little bit on that one. But we're trying to kind of get them all figured out. We're doing our best to keep up on all those. So yeah, our website, www.taylorbranchlonestarramblers.com, is probably the easiest way to kind of get routed to all those social media platforms.
You got a new song. I know you have a new video that hopefully will soon you'll be able to download. But if you want to right now, talk about the Kickstarter and really the process and really where you're hoping to take this.
The Kickstarter kind of came into play. I guess it was about 6 months kind of in the making. you know, what you see as far as what the Kickstarter is, as far as putting together the video, working with Motion Theory Media, Trevor Lamb over there, like he came down, he spent hours and hours and hours. I could talk a lot. So we spent, I don't know how many hours working on that. The intro video, but that was shot all the way back in July. And then working with, you know, Steve Shady is producing, Echo Labs Studio in Denton, getting everything kind of all moved around. Steve is actually Billy Nelson's head engineer. So like trying to figure that out, get the timing all set up. We were trying to get this going and COVID hit and everything kind of just fell apart. So we were like, okay, let's try and figure this out. So just before Kickstarter was even launched or anything was going on, there was probably about 6 months worth of like scheduling and trying to figure out who was doing what, who we wanted involved in this, who was interested in being involved and working with us. So behind the scenes, it's been nuts. And then you're running it right, 30 days is about all you probably really want to do. And that comes from several people that I spoke with and different marketing people. It's been wild. I think this is Friday was our first full weekend. We got, 19 days left on this Kickstarter. It's been a hard year, and so if people are able to donate, it's great. If not, please like, share, comment, follow the band. As of right now, we got like 19 days left. I think we're 40% funded. So we're moving and shaking on it. It's moving in a good direction. Thanks to people like you, Nick, on Bandwagon TV for having us on here.
Yeah, of course.
We've been reached out to work with a lot of different people. And really, this is the big thing. It's getting it out to as many people as possible, giving them that opportunity to see us, to hear us, to know what we're doing. We're going to be releasing several songs on there. My Ghost is the video that's currently out right now. That song will be a full band version of that on the upcoming EP, Stay the Course. So it's going to be fun, man. It's been a wild journey, and we're still just hanging in there doing our thing. So worth it.
Yeah, I mean, coming from me, I did a Indiegogo campaign and really didn't do enough research. So I saw really there wasn't any momentum, and you have to have that when you start. And then when you start, then it's just, you know, marketing and I didn't really know what I was doing, so it was kind of like a trial by error. So I can appreciate the amount of work it takes to do a successful campaign. So I appreciate you and the guys and really your whole team because I know how much work it takes to do this. So that's why another reason why we wanted. I'm glad that we connected through sharing, you know, your ideas and having this Kickstarter campaign out. So I really appreciate that here with Bandwagon. We realize hard work, man. So work wins.
I understand.
Yeah. We need a song. Now, I also know that you guys are performing, is it this Saturday?
This coming Saturday, 21st, yeah.
Oh.
If you haven't made it out to Bear Bells Barbecue, we're going to be out there Saturday night. We got Billy and the Blue Lots. So they're going to be opening, and then Preston Timmons will be opening before him. He'll be actually cracking the show off. I think show's starting at 7. And like I said, there's some surprises. So if you're on the fence, whether or not you want to come out, I'd recommend coming out and catching this show. It's going to be something for the books, for sure.
Well, hey, thanks. Taylor Branch and the Lone Star Ramblers, we appreciate your time. We're going to drop you off.
We're going to let you hear My Ghost.
Taylor, this is Taylor Branch, and we hope to talk to you soon and hopefully see you live.
All right, man. Be safe. Reflected in you.
all these sounds will play out me someday. Oh Lord, I well, I tried to give it up, Lord, I tried to put it down, but the sun keeps me highway bound. Well, the songs I gotta sing and the stories I gotta tell, I'm a little south of heaven, doing my best to outrun hell. Oh. And oh, my darling, darling, I pray, I hope these songs play out for you someday. Oh Lord, I pray. Oh my darling, darling, I pray, I hope these songs play out for you someday. Oh. Change and give it all I got.